Hello everyone, welcome to my Roblox scripting series where I teach you how to script on Roblox. In this video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about referencing and variables. So first, we're going to insert a script. Right click on server script service in the Explorer, select insert object, and select a script. You can delete the first line in the script. Now let's say we want to change a property of the baseplate, for example its transparency. We first need to reference the baseplate. Now referencing basically means to point to an object. In order to reference the baseplate, I'm going to show the computer where to go using the stop method. I'm going to start at the top, which is the game, and then point to the workspace, and then the baseplate. Now to access the transparency of the baseplate, you can use the dot method again to get the transparency. The dot method basically tells the computer, hey, I'm going to access a child or property of this object. From here, I can set the transparency to whatever I want. Granted, it is a number between 0 and 1. I'm going to set the transparency to 0.5 and run the script. To run a script, select the tab at the top where it says test, click the arrow below the play button, then click run. As you can see, the transparency of the baseplate is now 0.5 and we can see through the baseplate part in the workspace. Referencing can get tedious and hard at times. For example, if I wanted to access a part in the workspace that had a lot of parents like this, I would have to start from the game, go to the workspace, and all the way down to that part. And I would have to do this every time I want to do something to that part. That's where variables come in. Variables are basically values that hold whatever you give them. For example, I can create a variable that holds the reference to this part. That way, I only have to type out the long reference only once, and next time I can just call the variable name if I want to change it again. Now if I change the transparency of the variable named my part, you can see that it has done the same thing. Variables can hold more than just references. They can hold numbers, booleans, which are true false values, strings, which is text, and more. For example, I can make a variable named new transparency and set that equal to 0.5 or whatever transparency I'd want. Then I can take the reference variable, my part, and set its transparency to new transparency. It has the same effect. While you can hold references and variables, you can also change the values of variables later on in the script. Right now, my part is the part under all these other objects, but I can change the value of my part to another object by setting the variable again like this. Now, my part holds the reference to the baseplate. In addition, you can store property value. If I want to hold the transparency value of the baseplate, I can store it in a variable. In this case, I'm holding it in a variable called baseplate transparency. Beware that changing this variable later on will not change the property value. This means that if you store the property value of the baseplate into a variable, you still must change the baseplate's property using a reference to the baseplate and using the dot method to set the transparency. You can also set variables to hold nothing. This is for special use cases where you want to have a variable, but you don't know what value it will hold, or you need it for later on in the future. You can set a variable to hold nothing by using the nil keyword, or just by initializing the variable. They both do the same thing. In just about every script you have, you will be referencing and storing variables. If you don't want to reference every time you want to do something to an object, use a variable. Thanks for watching. Please leave a comment on how you felt on the video, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.